This is the Darrell Walker Coaches Show, presented by Stevens. And now, head coach of your Trojans, Darrell Walker, and your host, the Hall of Famer, Ray Tucker.
It's a new year and a new league for our Little Rock Trojans. We're now in the Ohio Valley Conference, and Darrell Walker, a new league and a relatively a new team for you.
Yeah, basically a new team. Moved to the OVC. It's kind of strange sometimes. You're not in the Sun Belt, and I watch some Sun Belt scores come up, and I go, wow, Georgia State beat so-and-so, but now I'm in the OVC, and it's a good conference for us.
Yeah, I do that. I pick up the Sunday paper, and I start looking at the Sun Belt scores, and we need to get that fixed where we got a little box in the newspaper where it has all of our scores. You played a tough non-conference schedule. Let's talk about that very quickly.
Talk about it. I mean, do I have to reminisce that conference? I mean, probably the 40th or 50th toughest schedule in the country this past season. I mean, we have to raise money around here, and it was a lot of them were some money games, and a lot of them was on the road. I think we played maybe three home games during the regular season, maybe four max, and everybody else was playing 7 and 8. So hopefully that'll change for us next year. But it was a tough schedule, and hopefully it'll help us down the line.
You know, along the way, we had an 11-day road trip, or maybe a 12-day road trip.
About 12 days.
Really tough on your guys.
I thought it was tough. I thought it was a great experience for our guys. We went to the University of San Francisco. We played the University of Indiana. Mike Woodson was nice enough to give us a great Thanksgiving dinner with all teams together. I thought that was a great what he did. We went to Napa Valley. We were in San Francisco. We've been all over the place. Then we went to Miami, Ohio. It was a 12-day trip, and I thought at times my guys got tired. It wore us down a little bit.
We had a chance to visit with the former Bulls great, Bill Cartwright, out in San Francisco.
Yeah, Bill Cartwright was my teammate. We won the championship in 1993 with the Chicago Bulls, the first three-peat team when John Paxson hit the shot. It was good to catch up with Billy C.
We had a little episode here at the Stevens Center over the holidays when we had a cold burst and the floor flooded, and we opened up our conference season on the road, so to speak, across the river in North Little Rock.
Yeah, first of all, I want to give kudos out to my athletic director, Joyce Lee. I thought he did a great job of getting Simmons Banks to let us come in and play that game against Tennessee Martin and to get this floor fixed quickly so we can have a game against Lindenwood here. So a little bit of Lake Michigan came through here and the pipes bust a little bit and messed up the Jack Stevens Center, but we got it back working now.
All right, we're well into Ohio Valley Conference play, four games into the season. We'll take a look at highlights when we come back with more of the Darrell Walker Coaches Show.
Great seats at a great price. Get them safer, simpler, and smarter with Ticket Smarter. A proud partner of the biggest names in live sports and events, including ESPN events and iHeartRadio. Ticket Smarter has seats for over 125,000 live events and 48 million tickets for sale. All backed with the Ticket Smarter 100% ticket guarantee. Thinking about your next great live event? Think smarter. Think Ticket Smarter. Get your tickets your way guaranteed at TicketSmarter.com.
Sport builds us up. It strengthens our bodies. It strengthens our resolve. Sport teaches us lessons of grace or humility or humanity, and that we're far more powerful together. Winning the hour or winning the year, we're winning our lives. We're winning our way. Because while a season is short, fierce is forever.
The Ohio Valley Conference, Little Rock and Lindenwood are the two newest members of that league, and they squared off here at the Jack Stevens Center. We'll take a look at highlights of that one, Coach.
Yeah, it was a really good basketball game. For us, it was a good basketball game for the first 20 minutes. The second half was not a good basketball game for us, but the first half we got after, that's Ante right there, a little hook shot right there. Jordan Jefferson played pretty good for us, a little floater that he shoots all the time. He's been playing well for us of late. That's us giving up an easy basket that we shouldn't have given up. But it was a good basketball game, like I said, Ray, for the first 20 minutes. I thought we really played good basketball in the second half. I thought we really just bogged down, got lackadaisical out there, got soft, and they came back in the game and made a run, and we folded and give them their due. They got the win, and we lost this game, a game that we shouldn't have lost.
We were up by 20 in the first half. I think they got it down around 10 by intermission.
Yeah, I thought we got a little tight when they made a little run, and I told my team the teams are going to make runs sometime, and we just couldn't overcome it. We're still a young basketball team. We still need to grow up a little bit as a team. I've told my team that, but, you know, that's part of the conference play right now.
Well, the game against Tennessee Martin, you were up big. They made a 16-0 run, and then your team held them off. So
yeah, but they made a 16-0 run, but we were up 25-30 yeah. points, and you can't do that. We should have closed that game out and won by 20 points, but we didn't.
We talked about, you and I have talked about this. The Sun Belt was a guard-oriented league. There were a few good big guys sprinkled around. This is a guard-oriented league, the Ohio Valley.
It's just like the Sun Belt. The OVC got a lot of good guards in this league. And our guard play, to be honest about it, is going to have to get a little bit better. But overall, like I said, Ray, we're a very young basketball team. We're still trying to grow and still trying to figure it out. And hopefully we can figure it out on this next road trip we got coming up down the line.
DJ Smith draining a three there, Coach.
Yeah, DJ hasn't been shooting the ball well lately at all. And it was good to see him make some shots against SEMO. He had been struggling from the field. Overall, I thought SEMO played a really good basketball game. We did, too. Every time we would get it down to 2 or 3 points, we would make a bonehead mistake and give the ball back to them, and they would get a bucket. With 1:15 left in the game, we gave up an easy layup with 5 seconds on the clock. So we had our chance to win the basketball game. We didn't protect home, and now we got to go on the road and try to win some games.
You know, people don't quite understand that there's an imaginary hump there.
And, it is.
And if you ever get over the hump, I've done probably 800-plus games. If you get over that hump, the other team, and you end up winning.
Yeah, we couldn't get over the hump. Like I said, we made a lot of mistakes down the line. Give SEMO their due. I'm one of these coaches when teams are well coached and they come in and they beat you, I always like to give respect to the other coaches. I thought they did a great job here. We had our chances, just didn't get it done.
That young man right there, Branson.
Yeah, he came off. He hurt us bad.
He came in averaging 5, and I think he ended up with 19.
He ended up with 19, and they had 30 bench points, and a lot of that was because of him getting 19 off the bench.
That's Myron Gardner, one of the better players in the league.
Yeah, Myron has a chance to be player of the year in this conference, but he's going to have to be more consistent, and we're going to have to start winning some basketball games. That was a big play right there when he drove by Chris Walker for that and one. That was a big play. You know, CJ's knocking down a shot right there to get us within one, and we had a chance, and that's the bonehead play right there. We fell asleep defensively. He slashed in for a layup. They go back up by 4.
Guy shoots it from 8 feet.
Exactly.
All right. We'll take a pause. We talked about the outcome of those two games. Didn't go in our favor. You got to protect home court, and we didn't do it.
No, we didn't do that at all, and I've talked to my team. The year we won the Sun Belt, we lost at home one time, and we've lost at home twice already. Once again, this team is young and still trying to find itself, and I'm trying to prod and push them all different type of ways, Ray, trust me, to see if we can get back to winning.
All right, as much as I hate to say this, Coach, we're back on the road again. All right, we'll take a pause. Back with more of the Darrell Walker Coaches Show right after this.
It's time to expect more from yourself, from us, from the typical college experience. UA Little Rock offers world-class programs, including business, computer science, criminal justice, cybersecurity, engineering, and nursing. But there's so much more. Expect to be amazed by state-of-the-art facilities. Expect to be challenged by motivated faculty. And expect a welcome place in the heart of Arkansas. University of Arkansas at Little Rock.
Feeling down and dirty, feeling kind of mean. It's time I had a good time, ain't got time to wait. Fill my eyes with that double vision. No disguise for that double vision. Ooh, double vision.
Darrell Walker, back on the road again. I think you played like 9 of your first 13 games on the road, something crazy. We're in conference play. We need these after losing 2 at home.
Yeah, we got to make up ground at USI on the road, starting with them, and then Eastern Illinois. They're a solid basketball team. I've been watching them on film. But I'm more concerned about my team. We need to play better, and we just got to play better as a team. Southern Indiana pushes the ball up the court. They got some pretty good guards. They got a beautiful facility, no doubt about that. But they've been struggling themselves on the road, and they're pretty solid at home, so we got to get after these guys.
your guys should be used to being on the road.
Man, we have been on the road so much this season. This has been a tough year. We've played so many games on the road with a young basketball team, and I'm hoping that we mature in the next 2 to 3 weeks, Ray, and start really running off 4, 5, 6 games in a row.
You know, sometimes players say they like to play on the road, but let me tell you what, the road has not been kind to us.
No, it has not been kind to us at all, and some of it has been self-inflicted, and some of them is just we've been on the road too much. I looked at other records in the OVC, Ray, and a lot of teams have played 7 or 8 games at home. That's why their record is so much better than us, because they played at home, and I didn't have that luxury of playing at home this year. So hopefully we can get on this road and get back to our winning ways. It's time.
So you start off with the USI, mm-hmm. and then
we head up the road 2 hours away to Eastern Illinois and play those guys, and then come back home. So we're on the road for about 2 days, 3 or 4 days on the road, and we, as a team, we got to keep bonding and see if we can get started with a win at USI. And we'll won't play, be easy, but we got to get after it.
We'll play on a Thursday night, and it'll be on ESPNU at 8:00.
Yep, be on ESPNU, and that's good for us. It's good for our school. It's good for USI too, because we're both two new schools into the conference, so everybody has a chance to see us on basically on national TV, and hopefully we give a good performance.
And I do like what I see in this video here. There are folks in the seats.
They draw good there. They were a powerhouse in Division II. They're well coached, so I'm looking forward to going in there and playing that game at 8:00. It's going to be fun.
Your guys healthy?
Everybody's healthy so far. Everybody's banged up a little bit, but this time of the year, everybody's going to be banged up a little bit. That's no excuses, right? We're all healthy. Everybody's in practice every day, so that's all that counts.
Is this league what you thought it would be?
Yeah, I think it's just like the Sun Belt. I think if you take the top 4 teams in the Sun Belt and you take the top 4 teams in the OVC, you're going to have the same level of play. So it's a good conference for us.
I tell you what, we'll get a chance to bond it a little bit, because we got a 6-hour bus ride the first trip, and then a 2-hour from between games, and then...
That's part of being in mid-majors. Most of the time, you're going to be on bus rides. And look, when I was at Clark Atlanta University, I took a lot of bus rides. So I'm used to bus rides. We have TV on there. We have satellite. So I'm used to it. You're not used to it, right? Well, you should be, because you've done it longer than I have.
What do you mean I'm not used to it? I've been doing this for a couple of decades at least. So anyway, Coach, look forward to the road trip and see if we can go get a couple of wins.
Yes, go Trojans.
All right. That's going to do it for this week's edition of the Darrell Walker Coaches Show. We hope you'll join us again next week. So long, everybody.